वेलकम फ्रेंड्स, द टॉपिक ऑफ टुडेज लेक्चर इज एयर गैप लेंथ डिज़ाइन। डिज़ाइन ऑफ एयर गैप लेंथ इज वेरी इम्पॉर्टेंट पार्ट, लाइक द डिज़ाइन ऑफ स्टेटर एंड रोटर। As we know that the induction motor is having two main parts, stator and rotor, and the stator is the stationary part of the machine and rotor is the rotating part of the machine. And in order to make the rotor free to rotate, we need to maintain a proper air gap between the stator and rotor. But the question is, how we decide the proper length of air gap which is required for the machine? Because the air gap length affects on other performance parameters of the induction motor, as well as we need to take care about the flux density in the stator teeth and rotor teeth while deciding the length of air gap. Now first we'll discuss on which parameters this air gap length affects. The air gap length directly affects on the power factor, overload capacity, and pulsation losses and noise. Power factor is a very important factor which affects by the length of air gap. If the air gap length increases, then the large flux is required to pass through it, and which increases the magnetizing current. The reason is, if the fluxes are passing through it larger, then we require large ampere turns to carry those fluxes, and as the magnitude of flux becomes increased, the less number of turns are sufficient to maintain the required MMF. But in order to balance that MMF, we require to increase the ampere. So it means the magnetizing current increases, and as we know that the magnetizing current is the large part of the no load current, and which is quadration in the voltage. So if you remember the vector diagram of the induction motor, then this is the magnetizing component current, and this is the magnetizing component current IM, this is the phi, and this is the active component of current, and this is the voltage. So you can see in this vector diagram, the magnetizing component of current is approximately quadrature to the applied voltage. So it means the angle between the voltage and magnetizing current is nearly 90 degree. So it reduces the power factor. It means the increased value of the magnetizing current lowers the power factor. So whenever we increase the air gap length, we need to compromise with the power factor, and as we know that the power factor directly affects on the efficiency So it means it directly affects on the performance of induction motor. Along with this, the air gap length affects on the overload capacity. As we have already discussed in the design of stator or design of rotor case also, if the large flux is passing through the air gap, then less number of turns are required. So if we increase the air gap length, it passes a larger flux through it and the less number of turns are required to produce the EMF, which increases the overload capacity. And the third factor which affected by the air gap length is the pulsation loss and noise. If the air gap length increases, the amount of scattered flux increases, and the scattered flux is also known as the zigzag leakage flux. And this zigzag leakage flux normally varies inversely as the air gap length. It means if the air gap length increases, then the amount of zigzag leakage flux decreases. So just in order to reduce this pulsation and losses, we need to maintain a large air gap. So here, if we maintain the large air gap, then we get the increased overload capacity as well as the pulsation and losses and noise becomes reduced. But we need to compromise with the power factor, and therefore the power factor is a very important factor which directly affects the performance of machine. And therefore, whenever we need to design a good power factor machine, we have to go for the minimum as possible length of air gap. If we maintain the minimum possible air gap length, we get a design of good power factor. In other words, we will get the design of the good efficiency. Now, what are the different expressions which are normally used to calculate the air gap length? The air gap length can be calculated by using the various expressions. Usually, to calculate the air gap length, we are using the expression LG is equals to 0.2 plus 2 under root D into L, where the D and L are the main dimensions, and this expression we are using normally to calculate the length of air gap. Air gap length can be calculated at certain constraints also. If the velocity constraint is given, then you can go for the air gap length is equals to 0.125 plus 0.35 D plus L plus 0.15 into V. And in few cases, if the machine is said to be a large machine, then you can calculate the LG by neglecting the length. LG is equals to 1.3 under root D. But whenever the constraints are not given in example, like the velocity constraint is not given in the example, and it is asked to calculate the length of air gap, go for the first equation. Except it is not said in the example, the given machine is a large machine, but it is asked in the example that you have to consider the given machine as a large machine, then It means they are asking you to take this expression for the calculation of air gap length. Otherwise, the normal and common equation by which we are finding the length of air gap is LG is equals to 0.2 plus 2 into under root dN. Friends, the usual value of the air gap length is between 3 to 5 millimeters, and but usually it is not assumed. We have to calculate this value by using the expression. So I hope you understood how to calculate the length of air gap and how the length of air gap affects on the other performance parameters of three-phase induction motor. Thanks for watching.